right, question number five. Okay, this question asks how to find the derivative of arc sine x all squared. Okay, so the derivative of arc sine. Arc sine of x squared. Okay, I'm going to rewrite this just because this would be the preferred way that it's written. For me, I like writing arc sine as the inverse sine. They're the same thing, arc sine and the inverse sine. So I just want to familiarize you with the two ways of writing it. It's just a little bit shorter. Maybe not, I don't know. that's what we'll be using. But just know that there are two equivalent ways of saying the same thing. So let's start by looking at taking this derivative. We can see that we'll need to use the chain rule, okay? Because we have essentially a function within a function. We have square function, and we also have, you know, the arc sine function, all taking, you know, or altering x. So using our chain rule, if say we have a function that is equal to f of g of x, so essentially a function within another function, if you take the derivative of that, we get the function, or the derivative of the outer function, which is this, that should be a lowercase f. So this is the outer function here, and this is the inner function, outer and inner. So we take first the derivative of the outer function and we multiply it by the derivative of the inner function. So let's look at what those are for our specific solution. Okay, I'm going to break it down really into really small steps. So if this part confuses you, you can just skip ahead to the next part and skip over this. But in order to break down the chain rule completely, I'm going to go through each step. So let's look at what this is, right? We have g of x, right? F of g of x, in this case, the outer function is the squared exponent, right? And if we're looking at what g of x is, well, g of x, the interior function, or the inner function, is our sine, inverse sine function, right? So remember, we were asked for the derivative of each, so that's what we're going to do, to find the derivative of the outer function. We need to use the power rule. How about I write power rule? And remember, we know what power rule is, and that's we have the derivative of a function to a power n here, then that is equal to the power times the function to the power of n minus 1. So let's say the derivative of our outer function is equal to, well, applying the power rule, we have n is equal to 2. So we have 2 g of x. And then instead of 2, now we have 2 minus 1, which is 1, or you don't need to write that at all. And now you can essentially sub in what g of x is, as we said up here. We know what g of x is already. That's sine, the inverse sine, of x. obviously you could have subbed it in here right away. I just wanted to leave it out in case that would be confusing. We know exactly what g of x is and the f of g of x. Okay, so working on this part now, remember we want the derivative of g of x. The derivative of g of x is the derivative of the inverse sine function. And from reference, we know that the derivative of inverse sine is equal to 1 over 1 half, 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared. So this might be something that you could look up or that you would have to maybe derive on an exam or something like that, or memorize. But that's a known solution. So yeah, that's what the g of x is equal to. So now when we're using our chain rule, if f of x is this main function here, we want the derivative of the main function. Inverse sine of x all squared. So that is equal to, using the chain rule, we have, I'll use a different color, we have the derivative of f of x, f of g of x, which we just found out to be here. So that's 2 inverse sine of x, 2 times the inverse of sine of x, times the derivative of g of x, which we saw was this, 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. Okay? And I just write this a little nicer. You have 2 times, well, I can write this as arcsine as well, I guess, so that we have both ways. All over the square root of 1 minus x squared. This is our final solution. So this is the solution, the derivative of arcsine of squared arcsine. And that is the final solution. So you can probably skip these internal steps here and do it straight away if it makes sense to you already. I just wanted to break it down so it was extra clear. And our solution gives that the derivative is the same thing. Okay, correct solution. Oops. And spell here. R, and there we go. And we can move on now. And the last.